A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 5th Jan, Sunday. On the front page you have, amid fury over Nankana Sahib attack, BJP uses it to justify CA, Citizenship Amendment Act. So opposition parties, after the Nankana Sahib attack, which was in news yesterday, we saw that Nankana Sahib, the Gurudwara here in Pakistan, had been attacked by a mob. So because of altercations initially. So now this incident, opposition parties are calling for PM's intervention in this incident, and BJP is using it as a justification that since you can see the 6 year how they are treated as a way, in a way, so it is using it to justify Citizenship Amendment Act. Shirumani Gurudwara Prabandhak Committee, SGPC from Punjab, also has sent its team to Pakistan. Then here you have India caught in crossfire as Trump invokes Delhi. So this is now after the incident which took place yesterday. We saw Iran's general Qasem Soleimani, he was assassinated in a drone attack or a helicopter attack, as such an airstrike by USA. And this happened after the US embassy in Iraq was barged in by a mob. So because this was through Iran support leaders, that's why Iran was targeted, and this general was the one which was the connect between Iran and Iraq. So here you can see now India is caught in the crossfire. What is said is, you can see Donald Trump blamed assassinated Iranian general for a spate of terror attacks, including one in Delhi. So this is now Trump blaming the assassinated general that he was the one responsible for terror attack in India, in Delhi too. So you can see, so this charge as such, Iran's ambassador to India has denied that the Iranian general was not involved. So now India doesn't know how to, what should it be its step, because this is what Trump says. So here you can see Minister of External Affairs declined to comment on Mr. Trump's statement, which brought New Delhi into the rising tensions between Washington and Tehran. So between USA, Iran, now India has also been dragged in. Then below you have BJP's pro-CAA number heats up Twitter. So this is regarding a number which has been, a mobile number as such, which has been released by BJP to asking people to give a call on this number if they support Citizenship Amendment Act. So now several accounts have come up on social media which try to lure users posing as women and offering fake Netflix accounts to use this number. And this is foreigner lodged in detention center dies. So this is Naresh Koch, who was marked as foreigner in 2018 by a tribunal in Golpara, Assam, and now he has died in detention. So he was in his mid-50s, and it is said he died from health complications. Then on page 5 you have, what if Pakistan sends spies as Hindus to India, asked CM at town hall meet. So this is New Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, who has raised this question. So we are providing citizenship through Citizenship Amendment Act to minorities from Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. So when they have been given citizenship here, the documentation which would be seen will be documents from their respective countries, like if they have a birth certificate, if they have any other documentation, plus also the religion. There is no document which says that this is your religion. So that is a question which has been raised here. On page 7 you have, Chilika may host over 1 million birds. So this is regarding Chilika Lake in Odisha. So it is the largest brackish water lake in the country, and here the migratory bird population has crossed 1 million mark for the first time in 2019, and the same thing is expected this year too. So here you should know about the Nalabana Bird Sanctuary also, which was notified in 1987 here in Chilika Lake. It is one of the largest congregations with 3,74,752 birds of 114 species been sighted. On page 8 you have, Kerala to take more cover under Miyawaki forest. So this is Miyawaki method of afforestation. We have seen this earlier also. It's very important. It has revolutionized afforestation by turning backyards into mini forests. So this is regarding urban forestation. It's a Japanese technology which has been pioneered by Japanese botanist Akira Miyawaki. and it has been adopted by Kerala to increase the green cover in urban and semi-urban areas. On page 9, you have 171 hospitals delisted from Prime Minister's health scheme after fraud. So this is regarding Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So the center's ambitious health insurance scheme has seen under its under the National Health Authority that it operates. So it has seen that 171 hospitals. It has more than 390 hospitals of over 19,000 empaneled hospitals across 9 states. So they have either served show cause notice, suspended or de-empaneled for alleged fraud. So they have been de-empaneled. FIRs have been lodged against 6 hospitals in Uttarakhand and Jharkhand. Quantum of penalties for these are more than 4.6 crores. So what is seen is there are big beneficiaries being listed under these hospitals under the scheme. So here you can see it was seen that wrongful enrollment of beneficiaries, like 3,785 village level entrepreneurs as such had been under Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana have been deactivated too. So here you can see, because whenever there is any hospitalization, for that payment is done by the government. So there are fake beneficiaries being created and the hospitals take benefit of it. Should know that insurance cover under Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana is of up to 5 lakh rupees per family. And this is research in India inadequate. So this is CNR Rao, one of the foremost chemists in India, scientists in India. He has said that neither the quality nor quantity is enough in research in the country. On page 10, you have Vyapam Pump Scam. CBI secures 94 convictions in 4 years. So this is regarding Vyapam. This is the agency, this was actually the agency in Madhya Pradesh which conducted entrance tests for admissions in educational institutions and government jobs. So this scam, which was unearthed in 4 years ago, it has seen CBI securing 94 convictions. It is pursuing 154 cases in this scandal of Madhya Pradesh. So Vyapam stands for the Hindi name. It's an acronym for the Hindi name Vyavsayik Pariksha Mandal of Madhya Pradesh, or in English called Professional Examination Board. So here there was a web created for committing frauds and getting people pass this entrance examination. People, posters were going and writing the examination, and there was a complete pyramid of till the top which was involved in this scam. So here that all was unearthed, and you can see there are 154 cases and 94 convictions so far in this case in the 4 years since the investigation began. On page 11, you have CA ends Assam Accord betrayal, BJP. So now BJP is saying that Assam Accord as such had given the cutoff date as 1951, but the NRC which was conducted in Assam had 1971 as a cutoff date. So this was betrayal of Assam Accord, because 1951 should be cutoff date is what BJP is saying. So it says that Citizenship Amendment Act will undo this damage. But you should know, under Citizenship Amendment Act, cutoff age is not 1951, rather it is 2014. So CAA cannot end Assam Accord betrayal at all. On international page, you have Hot and Dry Down Under. So this is regarding how Australia is experiencing an unprecedented drought-fueled bushfire crisis that has burned swathes of land across the continent over the last few months. So these are the incidents of bushfire seen here. You can see. So this is a disaster which has struck Australia. Also, Australian Prime Minister Scott Morrison faced renewed criticism after sharing bushfire-themed party campaign ads that opponents condemned as disgusting, and a respected defense association said that milking the crisis. That was milking the crisis. Then on business page, there is no important news you can see. This is regarding mutual fund, Nippon India Mutual Fund, and the Credit Suisse. They have SPAT and IRDAI. IRDAI has given a ruling, so tussle between them, between the Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India and Nippon and Credit Suisse, has been referred to Securities Appellate Tribunal. So this dispute is about pledging Reliance General Insurance shares. So this also is with respect to regulatory bodies, like IRDAI is also regulatory bodies, and SEBI rulings, they in appeal go to Securities Appellate Tribunal, SAT. So this is important in that context, how regulatory authorities function and how they get intermingled, because insurance related matters, IRDAI is the regulatory authority, and for shares, stocks related matters, it is Securities Tribunal which is the adjudicating authority. Then on Sundays, you also have FAQ coverage, which is frequently asked questions. So important issues which were in news over the week are discussed here in detail. So first one is West Asia headed for war? So this is regarding the killing of Iranian General Qasem Soleimani in Iraq. So how will this killing by a US drone attack impact the region, West Asian region? So that is detailed out. Will it result in a war, because we have seen gold prices rising, we have seen oil prices rising post this attack, Iran saying that it would take revenge. So yeah. And this is tussle over Belgavi. So this is a border dispute between Maharashtra and Karnataka. So what is it all about and what is the central government stand? So Maharashtra was formed from Marathi speaking regions, but some Marathi speaking region has also gone to Karnataka, and this is Belgavi region. So this presently is in Karnataka at border with Maharashtra. So this is a border dispute between the two states. So what is the central government stand on it? So that is detailed out here. Then this is, why has the US crippled the functioning of the WTO? So World Trade Organization has not been functioning as such because its appellate body, which acts as a Supreme Court for international trade, here USA is not appointing members. So that is, it is left with only one member now, who will not be able to deliver any rulings on pending trade disputes, because a minimum three members are required to adjudicate any dispute, and USA is not making appointments here. So USA is country which contributes major funds to the World Trade Organization. So largest share as such is of USA. So it not been providing support, and it not to function, implementing its duties like making appointments in this, then it is resulting in USA making WTO die. So is the World Trade Organization dying is a question. And why does America disregard the authority of the appellate body? So the appellate body as such gives rulings which go against USA. So USA is blocking the selection process, blocking funds for it. So that's what is happening at WTO. So this is an important issue. Then on Sundays in the Hindu newspaper, you also have science and technology coverage. So here you have this contrasting water wetting behavior used for anti-counterfeiting measures. So this smart interface embedded with two water wettabilities can hide or reveal information. So this is what this researchers at IIT Guwahati have developed, a new approach to anti-counterfeiting measures. So you can see extremely water repelling capabilities are there, and extremely water loving capabilities are there. So water repelling capability is called super hydrophobic, and extremely water loving capability is called super hydrophilic. So they can hide information or make it visible under certain definite conditions. So this technology has been developed here. And this is double burden of malnutrition, need for urgent policy action. So it says India has addressed the problem, but more needs to be done. So malnutrition problem, challenge of underweight is also there, plus double burden means challenges of overweight, obesity also, and increase in non-communicable diseases. So that is also there, plus malnutrition, as such is also there in the country. Means deficiencies are also there and excess is also there. So National Nutrition Mission of India has focused on both, but then there more needs to be done is what this article talks of. Then this is World Health Organization pre-qualifies serums low-cost pneumococcal vaccine. So this is Serum Institute of India, which is a Pune-based institute. It has pre-qualified, it has been pre-qualified by World Health Organization in December 2019 for the pneumococcal vaccine which it has developed. So vaccine will cost only $2 per dose, which is 30% cheaper than the Gavi price. So other vaccine which is presently being given. And this is how humans affect genetic connectivity of four mammals. So there are four wide-ranging mammals, jungle cats, leopards, sloth bears, and tigers. So these mammals were studied in central India, and how humans affect their genetic connectivity is detailed out here. Isolation of habitat patches can restrict animal movement, thus reducing genetic exchange and increasing extinction probability. Then on Sundays, you have this dispatches coverage in which important international developments are covered. So the first one is regarding Austria. So this is Sebastian Kurz, 33-year-old Austrian chancellor and from Conservative Party, and he has support from the Green Party now. So this is regarding political developments in Austria, in Europe, and the idea which is put forth here is regarding his Islamophobic agenda. Means, no, so like phobia means keeping it away. So the conservatives have this Islamophobic objective. And this is new law but old problems. So this is regarding Pakistan. So this is regarding the accountability ordinance. So opposition is critical of the changes brought about by the government in this accountability ordinance. So National Accountability Ordinance of 1989 has been changed. So what is this ordinance? A presidential ordinance. It is the new ordinance actually gives powers to National Accountability Bureau, which is an anti-corruption watchdog, and the new amendments as such are curtailing its powers and its jurisdiction limit. So the opposition here is protesting this move of the government. And below you have return of the green shirts. So this is regarding development in Brazil. So here you can see that in Brazil there was an attack which took place, attack on Backdoor Productions, which currently has been streaming comedy series on the life of Jesus Christ. So there is this group, cadres of the Integralist Front, which is inspired by European fascism, and they are back on Brazil streets now, it is said. So and next is no network in times of crisis. So this is regarding Bangladesh, how it shut down telecom services along the border, citing security reasons, but it was revoked later. So now this is a new way in which government takes action in the name of security, that telecom services are shut down. It's happened in Bangladesh. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aasha.com. Thank you.